Hello, welcome to our LVDS SerDes video series with Texas Instruments. My name is Charlie Tsai. In this video, I'll talk about how to determine pixel clock and data rate in display system, and explain the key terms used in calculation. In short, here is the formula on calculating pixel clock and data rate. Pixel clock equals to horizontal resolution times vertical resolution times frame rate times planking period factor. Data rate equals to pixel clock times bit per pixel. Now let's break down each term to see what they are and how to get them. Horizontal resolution and vertical resolution are probably the easiest term to understand. In fact, I bet many of you already know what they are. Common terms such as 480p, 720p, 1080p are used to refer to display resolutions. In general, display panels consist of many individual pixels. Horizontal resolution refers to the number of pixels in the display's width direction. And vertical resolution refers to the number of pixels in the display's height direction. A 720p display, for example, will have 1280 horizontal resolution and 720 vertical resolution, totaling 921,600 pixels for the display area. Frame rate usually carries the unit frame per second, which refers to the number of frames displayed on the screen in 1 second. 24 frames per second, 30 frames per second, or 60 frames per second are some of the common frame rates. Blanking period is the easiest to ignore when trying to calculate pixel clock and data rate, but it is a very important concept. To display the image in active display region, extra data or signals need to be transmitted to synchronize video lines, restore voltage level, and so on. These extra data should be considered when calculating pixel clock and data rate. Sync period, back porch period, and front porch period make up the whole blanking period. Horizontal and vertical directions have their own blanking period. In calculation, blanking period is typically represented as a factor or percentage. It is equal to the number of pixels in active region divided by the number of pixels in blanking region. A good rule of thumb for estimating the blanking period is to assume at least 10% blanking. Lastly, bits per pixel is the number of data bits used to represent a pixel. Here we have an example on how bits per pixel can affect image quality. As you can see, more bits used per pixel results in more color depths. Typically for RGB data, 18 bits per pixel or 24 bits per pixel are used. Generally, these parameters can be found in display panel's datasheet and can be changed based on different use cases. Now we have a basic understanding of the terms. Let's revisit the equations and look at an example. For a 720p 60 frames per second display with 10% blanking and 24 bits per pixel, the pixel clock should be 60 MHz, and the data rate is 1.44 gigabits per second. In many display systems, serializer and deserializers are used to transmit signals between processor and display panels to reduce cable count. TI with the leading serialization and deserialization technologies offer 3 generations of LVDS serializer and deserializer that's suitable for different display applications. Gen 1 LVDS SerDes can serialize 24 bits of data into 5 lanes and deserialize the data back to 24 bits. Gen 2 and Gen 3 LVDS SerDes can serialize 24 bits of data into 1 LAN and deserialize the data back to 24 bits. When selecting SerDes, we need to make sure both the serializer and the deserializer meet the pixel clock requirement and support the data rate we need. For full portfolio of TI's LVDS SerDes device, please visit ti.com/LVDS. Thank you for watching this video.